Yo, and welcome to Fishy Talks to His Monitor for 45 minutes or so. I'm reluctant to do voice tracks for my videos because this feels so odd, sitting at home and just talking to my PC. But anyway, that's still what I'm going to try to do now. Obviously, I'm not a native speaker, and while I think my English is pretty decent, I'm really not used to doing this, and I'm gonna struggle to find the correct word and stuff like that. That's just the way it's going to be. This is an old mission that we tried to record together as a group before, but it never quite worked out for several reasons. So yeah, it has been lying around for like a year, and at some point I decided, for a good reason by the way, to record this alone, to just try it on my own. The reason was that my internet provider decided that having a good connection was not worth my time. Apparently they have technical issues, like we have talked to other people who are living close to us, and yeah, apparently the whole village has internet connection problems, or had, when I had the connection issues that is in the past now. I recorded this when I pretty much didn't have any internet. Like, we would have internet for 30 seconds, then it would crash for 2 minutes. Which actually is kinda enough to watch a YouTube video kinda decently, surprisingly enough. Like, it would buffer a bit for 30 seconds and then I could watch for like a minute or so, then the connection would crash again. But yeah, I took out a book and then like watched YouTube for a minute or so. Then I read my book for a minute or so. This is an FW-190 A6, I think. As I said, I flew the mission like a month ago now. The time I made this mission is like a year ago or whatever. Trying to record it as a group really was unsuccessful. Bit of right rudder. Just try to stay on the runway, it doesn't matter, it's a super flat airfield that's very wide, and if I wasn't on the concrete part, that wouldn't matter at all, but it looks nicer this way. Gear up. Recording together as a group for a video that features 8 perspectives and 4 people, like I usually try to do, is really, really hard. There are technical issues, a ton of technical issues, there's always this, that and the other, and if that it wasn't enough, obviously we are only human beings and we do not fly perfectly, and that's one of the main reasons why there is now going to be a video of only me flying this. We tried it before, one time even with 8 people. That had so much potential, it could have been so cool. We had we had 2 complete flights of 190s. We even set it up in a cool way, where we put one flight in one TeamSpeak channel and the other flight in the other channel, so that we couldn't communicate with each other, apart from the flight leaders who could whisper to each other. Ah, that would have been so cool. I might have even made like 2 videos out of that, like make one video of one flight and another one of the other flight. Yeah, it had a lot of potential, but didn't work out. It didn't work out because we basically were all shot down pretty much immediately. Or like 5 of us or something, and yeah, when you make a video of 8 people and most of them get like shot down in the first engagement. I sometimes kinda show disasters like that, but I don't really want to do that. I mean, people complain enough how bad pilots we are in really successful missions. By the way, people asked what map this is, and this is Slovakia. I don't choose Slovakia because it is particularly fitting for the time or the scenario or whatever. I just choose it because it looks nice. At some point I populated the map with ground objects, like put AA there and there, put stationary tanks and camouflage nets, bunkers, whatever, and then I used that template to make other missions on it. So that's how this mission came to be. At this point I'm trying to assemble my flight and to follow the first flight. I took off with 7 AIs with a total of 8 190s, and I'm the leader of the second flight, so there are going to be 4 190s in front of me, then it's me and the 3 AIs which follow me. There they are, the friendlies at 11 o'clock. I don't really have much to comment about this part. Just try to stay in the rough area of the other flight and engage together if possible. If not, get into an advantageous position on your own. That is the upside on recording alone. If it goes wrong and if you get shot down, you just try again and nobody will ever know. What could I talk about? That's the obvious one. Recording problems that we had. Like, stuff that keeps us from producing those classic 8 perspective videos with 4 people, or like 10 perspectives with 5 people, and so on. I think the most I had was 14 perspectives with 7 people. The Zero mission, where I was in the Betty. Yeah, I think that was it. Yeah, we had potential for 16 perspectives and 8 people before, but as I said, those were usually disasters. So I'd say, first and foremost, what keeps us from recording together are technical issues. The recent months have been absolutely terrible. For some people, this game apparently just decided to not work anymore. And I was one of those, actually. So, yeah, that one issue that I had was super weird, and I couldn't figure out what the problem was for a long time. So the issue was that only in multiplayer, my game would randomly decide to crash. Obviously, I make these missions myself, so when I make these missions, they work fine. And then we played the same stuff in multiplayer, and it leads to random crashes. So I already was like, okay, what the... Because all the stuff in the mission obviously worked before in single player. Everything is fine, I can test the mission, it works. By the way, testing the mission is like 75% of the effort of making a mission. It's a lot of trial and error and just loading up the mission again and again and again. Like, you load up the mission, try it, then change something a little, try again, and yeah, repeat that for like 20 times. That's mission making in a nutshell. Then we load up that same mission in multiplayer, and yeah, we would like load up the mission, begin, and after something like a minute or two, my game would just randomly crash. It would, like, at the time I had 2 monitors, 2 screens, and my main monitor would go to black, and my second monitor would go to some solid color, usually some kind of brown, for like 2 seconds. Then I would be on my desktop and everything would be fine, just the game was gone. That monitor going to a solid color was already like a hint that it was a problem with my graphics card drivers. I didn't immediately figure that out. At first I thought, yeah, okay, you probably added some mod again that now is in conflict with something in multiplayer, whatever. So the search began. Try to make my IL-2 not crash. So I basically reverted to quote-unquote vanilla YPEG, so stock YPEG. Just YPEG out of the box and didn't add anything in JSGME or any other mod manually, whatever, and yeah, try it again, and it still would crash. So, yeah, the stock YPEG version obviously works for a lot of different people, and so that one couldn't be the issue. It couldn't be an IL2 version issue, basically. I mean, stock YPEG without enabling much stuff in JSGME, or without enabling stuff in JSGME at all, is pretty close to the vanilla game anyway, to be honest. Yeah, so that wasn't it. And at some point I discovered the Windows Event Viewer, and usually when my game crashed, I also had an NVIDIA driver crash. And Event Viewer shows you an error code. And that was very useful, because I put that error code into Google, and what it came up with was that my processor would overload my graphics card, and that made my graphics card crash. And I'm like, okay, that makes sense, because I recently upgraded my PC, but I didn't upgrade the graphics card, because those are really expensive right now. So, yeah, it made sense that my graphics card would bottleneck the rest of the PC. The graphics card is like 5 years old, and the PC is... the graphics card is 5 years old, and the CPU, motherboard, and RAM are really new. But that begged one question. How do you, like, throttle your CPU to not overload your GPU? I know that you can overtagged your CPU to run faster. Can I make it go slow? Yeah, that was not going to be a solution, I think, at least. So, yeah, I tried this, that, and the other with my graphics card drivers. Like, changed the settings with IL2. Like, yeah, I'm applying anti-aliasing, and yeah, pretty much that's it to the game with the NVIDIA drivers. So yeah, I fiddled with that, chose this and the other setting. Nothing worked. Still, I had game crashes. Oh, by the way, the testing if these game crashes would appear was a super annoying process. Because as I said, that happened only in multiplayer, so I had to create a multiplayer server to test this in. Luckily, I have two PCs at this point, and you often use one for hosting. So I spent like half a day sitting here, loading up the mission with one PC, then connecting to it with the other PC, then flying it for a minute or two, just waiting for the game to crash again. That, yeah, went on like that for like half a day, just loading up, crashing, and repeat. And then at some point I finally decided to, like, okay, you know what, let's try to use old graphics card drivers. I had recently updated my graphics card drivers to the newest ones because, hey, my game randomly crashes, let's use the newest drivers. So I googled NVIDIA drivers and I installed a version from 2017. And behold, that was the problem. I now have 4 years old graphics card drivers and my game doesn't crash anymore. Yay! That's a group of 8 110s at my now 2 o'clock low. Yes, 2 to 3 o'clock low. I decided to, like, stay with those a bit for a while. I was reaching the target area roundabout now. This is a free hunt mission, and I'm just supposed to go to a certain area and patrol it, see if any enemy aircraft arrive. In this version, obviously, I do not have any ground control guidance or radar or anything. I could possibly add command and control, but yeah, even at this point I was shy to even add command and control, because when people have connect have problems connecting and some people's games just randomly crash. We wanted to rule out that the IL2 version was at fault, so we pretty much wanted to use Wirepack out of the box as it was. I now know that wasn't the issue, but at the time, yeah, that was the way I was thinking. Using Wirepack out of the box, like it comes, is a good idea, because having the exact same game version is really important to be able to record in this game. Like start an in-game recording, a replay. Even if you use different textures for airfields, it can lead to you not being able to start a successful in-game recording. Huh, the friendly AA is firing at something. What could that mean? There are enemy aircraft around. So here I spotted something, I guess? Ah, yes, I think that was a P2 that I dove on. Or a group of P2s. Yeah, there they are. The pilot is sitting a bit too high in this modded cockpit, so if it looks that I'm, like, watching over my side a lot, yeah, that's just because I originally flew this without the cockpit mod and recorded it with the cockpit mod. First unsuccessful attack. I mean, I hit him, but he didn't go down, obviously. These attacks look so crazy from the bomber's perspective. When you come in from 80 degrees above them. A lot of friendlies were on those bombers, so I already was kind of uninterested in attacking them. Attacking them would probably lead to some enemy fighter AI to suddenly appear, so you want to have your energy and altitude. But I still went for a few attacks, I think. Would have missed when I shot there, so I didn't. I love that Tracer's mod. And there we go, kill number one. Immediately checking 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock high, the direction from which the enemies were supposed to appear. But apart from a 110 on my 9 o'clock, I appear to be pretty clear. Didn't see anybody at 1 o'clock or so. Ah, there's a contact. See, there is a guy, just not in a position to attack me or anything. I think I did a head-on on him. Yeah. And people always tell me that I'm such a bad pilot. Yeah, right. Kill number two. I'm really not the best pilot in the world, and I never said so. Sometimes in cases like this, I'm just the only option. I spend so much time mission making and video making. The times when I actually sit down in a fighter aircraft and just try to get a successful missions are pretty rare, actually. I think the last time I flew alone was when I made that Corsair video of me flying alone. And even that wasn't really for fun, that was for producing that video as well. That was also one of the times where we tried that mission with a bunch of people before and couldn't get anything useful out of it. Second head-on, and yeah, this time I didn't shoot as nicely. But it's better to just throw a bunch of lead in their direction than not to do anything. One really shouldn't head on AIs, but on the other hand, I'm a 190, I have 4 cannons. Dogfight. I don't like dogfights. I like energy fighting. But on the other side, yeah, when people complain, you dogfight dead and blah aircraft, or you dogfighted, yeah, you're right. What people always say is, you dogfighted in dead and dead aircraft. Guys, it depends which aircraft you fight. Such and such aircraft is not always an energy fighter. It depends on the enemy. I just had another of those issues come to mind that kept us from recording a mission forever. As you might have seen in the recent stream, we tried to record a mission in Korea with F-86s, B-29s and MiG-15s. Which obviously is a super cool scenario, like, hey, let's do Korea B-29 escort in an F-86. Nice! So, at some point we tried to record the Korea stuff, for which we needed to enable a JSGME mod in YPEG. YPEG comes with a built-in Korea mod. When you enable that, a lot of files in hashtag SAS folder, so in your mods folder, get automatically replaced, blah blah blah. And then you have stuff like the F-86 and the MiG-17, or MiG-15. Yeah, MiG-15, if I said 17 before, I meant 15. That program is supposed to make this stuff an option. You are supposed to be able to enable it and disable it again, and the program is supposed to automatically restore all the files that were there before you enabled the mod. And finding out that that process went wrong was a whole different story as well. Like, I told people, hey, enable the Korea mod in your JSGME, blah blah blah, we try the mission, okay, next time we fly, disable that mod again, and yeah, in theory, people should have the exact game version again that they had before they enabled the mod. And then we had all kinds of weird issues. Like, when you join a multiplayer server in cooperative mode, it's supposed to show a briefing screen and a button that says aircraft. So when you press the aircraft button, there is a list of aircraft that you can choose. And for one of our guys, the menu would disappear, and I think his screen would go in pretty much into a solid color or something. And yeah, his mouse would disappear, couldn't control the game anymore. So every time he joined the mission and selected aircraft, he would have to restart the game. Which is like super annoying for everybody, because 3 people or so are waiting in their aircraft, in their slots, and just waiting that the mission begins, and another guy just can't join his aircraft. Game crashes all the time, basically. Doesn't like really crash and you are on desktop, but you can't use it anymore. And then the troubleshooting begins. 3 people are ready to go, 1 can't, and so everybody has to wait, and we have to figure out why his game does that. So, yeah, the way I am, okay, what mods do you have enabled? What did I tell you to enable before? Maybe some of that, of those mods is an issue. If that doesn't work, okay, restore. Yeah, by the way, I'm looking really hard at that aircraft and I'm like, oh no, that's a 190, is it? And then, yep, I'm getting shot at. How did I miss those 3 guys? Yeah, that's when you fly unrealistic. Sometimes your situational awareness just isn't perfect. Give me a break, okay? The guy who had the problem with not being able to join his aircraft basically had a stock vanilla already, so I was sitting there like, what the heck? What's the problem here? What why does it keep doing that? And at some point I said, like, show me what is in your SFS auto folder. That's a different story. Like, that folder is supposed to... You are supposed to put .sfs files into there that are then automatically loaded by the game when you launch the game. And .sfs files are the native file type that the game is delivered in. So that fastens up the loading process. It's very handy if you give the game SFS files to load instead of stuff in your mods folder. And that's why the Korea mod also comes in SFS files. When you enable the mod in JSGME, it puts a whole bunch of files into your mods folder, but all the models and stuff, like the F-86 3D model and the MiG-15 3D model, stuff like that, all that is in a separate SFS file that gets put into SFS auto. Now, when you disable the mod in JSGME, that file is supposed to be deleted again. Like, the JSGME is supposed to restore the game to the same state it was in before you enabled it. And it failed to do that. So, the guy's game would load, like, different Korea stuff when it wasn't supposed to. So that's why he couldn't join an aircraft. Stuff like this always happens when you don't have the exact same game version. You can have a weird installation with all kinds of stupid mods, it doesn't matter. If you take that complete installation and send it to your buddy, multiplayer is most probably still going to work. But as soon as there are little differences, that makes problems. And this time, it wasn't our fault. It wasn't like I told somebody to install some mod that wouldn't work or anything. Nope. JSGME failed to work properly. Uh-oh. Inbound. At this point I decided to dive, because the 190 is supposed to be good at diving, right? Yeah, not as good as the P-47 or whatever. I know. But it felt like I was a bit faster than him, so I just kept going. Yeah, trouble was basically over at this point. All good. Oh no, that was not a good decision to break off there, buddy. Anyway, so yeah. The Korea video has also been in the making for like 5 months. That the first tries that we recorded that in is like 5 months ago. I tried to use the graphics extender for that video, and sadly, the extender doesn't work quite properly with the Korea map that we want to use. It looks so nice when that bug isn't there, but there is a bug, and that one is so annoying. It's that the ocean looks plain white, or some weird white texture, in some areas. And that's a hard border. It doesn't like slowly begin to become that white weird texture. Nope, it's a hard border, and that looks super odd. So yeah, whose name I'm not supposed to say, actually fixed that issue, and we now have a version of the map and the mission that we could fly. But yeah, last time, as you saw on stream, we kind of team killed each other. I mean, I like nearly shot down Krabby, and it otherwise wasn't a success. Oh yeah. It otherwise wasn't a successful mission. There was one huge issue again. So one thing that has been in development for a long time are our AI formations for bombers. And yeah, we have a special B-29 formation. Darky made... Oh, no, I mentioned his name. He, whomst may not be named, made a special B-29 formation. Only for this mission, basically. And as it turns out, that formation is too close. It leads to all kinds of issues with the AI. bomber AI loves to jettison their bombs at the first sign of trouble. When they get shot down or take evasive action or something like that, they often like kinda fly over each other. So when they then, during that evasive action or whatever, or when they get shot down and veer to one side, when they then jettison their bombs, they often bomb each other accidentally, which then leads to catastrophic results because, yeah, I don't think hitting another aircraft directly below you would trigger a bomb fuse in reality, but in IL-2 it does. So one bomber jettisons the bombs above another bomber, the bombs go off, and like 7 bombers just explode. So in that Korea mission that we streamed, we flew back to the bombers at some point and they were basically all gone, and we were like, what happened? Because, and especially I was like, what happened? Because I trimmed down the number of enemy MiGs before to make the B-29s more survivable anyway, and then I see the bomber formation for the second time in the mission and they are all gone. I'm like, what happened? So yeah, I checked the replay and all the B-29s blew themselves up. From a quality standpoint, that's something that I don't want to show, so we've been trying that mission for like 15 times over 5 months with different people and so on and so on. It never quite worked out. Recently I checked out that MiG-15 take we did. Markham says it was such a good take and make a video of it, and I'm like, alright, let me check it out. And I load up the first replay. I usually load the replay of the guy whom should not be named. I load up those first because he usually is the flight leader. And he's usually very, very reliable when it comes to technical stuff. And even if it's wrong, like in this time, it's not his fault. And it wasn't. So what's the problem with this replay? Yeah, it's supposed to be an F-86 replay escorting B-29s. And the replay begins and we are in Africa in an MPC-202 on the ground in the desert. I'm like, oh no. As I said before, there are issues where when you don't have the exact same game version that you cannot start a recording. And that probably was the case with this one. I just took a little break from recording and made myself a nice cup of coffee. So yeah, where was I? Technical issues while recording that Korea mission, yeah. We also had a pretty successful F-86 take, which I sadly cannot make a video of or don't really want to. I checked the first replay, it worked. I checked the second replay and so on. Yeah, okay, this works fine. Let's start to record this. So one evening, I think I loaded up a podcast in which they watch The Two Towers, Lord of the Rings. And so I watched Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers, with voice commentary, basically. That was nice. Yeah, so on the one PC, I would be recording IL-2, like load up an F-86 replay, start the recording, the Fraps recording, and then sit on my couch, watch Lord of the Rings, and whenever one replay would be done, I would load up the next and film the stuff like that, pretty passively, but yeah, I would have like 3 hours of footage or so, and then the two towers wouldn't even be over. It was a very nice plan. And then, some days later, as I said, I had the first 3 replays filmed from the interior when I don't have to do anything, it's from the inside, like it's just some pilot's perspective. Then I loaded up the 4th replay and my game crashed and I'm like, no. Or did my game crash? No, never mind. But the replay didn't work, that was the point. So the 4th perspective isn't usable and I'm like, no. Oh boy, here we go again. Flying a fighter in a mission which has a lot of stuff going on sometimes really is fun. I was really positively surprised by this. Like, I had a bunch of fun, and this also was pretty successful. Like, I got a bunch of kills, yeah. It was really nice. What else did we try to record that didn't work out? Ah, just yesterday, from when I record this, we flew Helldiver for the third time, I think. Moostick and he, who should not be named, tried that one before, and in that try, he who should not be named and me had an air-to-air collision. Yeah. In this try, another so annoying thing. It was a really, really good try. We were four people, and yeah, we took off from Intrepid in our Helldivers, joined with the other Helldivers, flew to the enemy island, dropped our bombs, and then attacked with rockets. Yeah, usual stuff. Markom was shot down while already flying home again, like he was not on the island anymore. It wasn't AA, but it was a fighter that shot him down. I got a permanent fuel leak, so I was lagging at home, like hoping that the fuel would at least last to the aircraft carrier. Boris was escorting me, and Krabby was going home on his way alone. Was on his way going home alone. This is the proper order of the words, I guess. And yeah, we actually reached the aircraft carriers. I didn't run out of fuel earlier. And I tried to land, and yeah, when I tried to land on the approach, I ran out of fuel. So I was like, okay, you did this before in the aircraft carrier landings video. No problem, you're gonna do this. But yeah, I had flown the Helldiver in a long while, and I wasn't quite sure about the landing speed. I thought landing speed would be around 80 miles per hour, which I guess it would be if you had an engine still. But if you have to glide, you have to go a bit faster because the engine doesn't pull you. So I ran out of speed at like 90 miles an hour. So I like 100 yards away from the aircraft carrier, ran out of airspeed and dropped into the water. Yeah, not the end of the world. Stuff happens, but yeah, it still was a heartbreaker. But that didn't break the deal for making a video out of that. Next, Krabby would go in for landing, and it wasn't a nice landing or anything at all. He failed to catch a wire, but that also wasn't the deal breaker. The deal breaker was that Krabby's game randomly crashed while he was rolling on the deck, and I was like, and we all were like, oh no, not a random game crash again. And also in that unfortunate moment, the deal breaker, now here it comes. I mean, if Krabby disappears mid-replay because his game crashed, we can just say in the game, in the video, guys, yeah, his game crashed, no, can't show his perspective anymore, whatever. Also, obviously, I have the live TeamSpeak recording, and we were talking about how Krabby's game crashed, so yeah, it wouldn't be surprising when he was gone. The dealbreaker was that when we tried to load up Krabby's replay, it didn't work. This time, my game would just crash when I tried to load up that replay, so Krabby's perspective was gone. Is that such a big deal? One would think, can't you just film Krabby's perspective from somebody else's replay or whatever? Hold on, take a sip of coffee here. That's still pretty warm. And the answer to that is, can I film it from somebody else's replay? Technically, yes, for most of the time. But it's kind of random what weapons are displayed. Like when Krabby uses a bomb, it's random if in my replay that bomb is visible. If it isn't, you can see it under his wing hanging there. And then when he uses it, it just disappears. And obviously also the explosion from the bomb and everything isn't visible. The only thing that is visible is the ground objects being destroyed. That's still gonna show up. But that's really not that nice, especially with rockets, with those big white rocket trails that are supposed to be visible. There's just gonna be like that little fire effect on the ground. Oh, by the way, Boris landed successfully. Boris had a really nice mission with. He got the most points, he landed successfully, he escorted me home. Really cool. And then, yeah, sorry, I can't really make a video out of this. I mean, I guess I technically still can make a video out of that. I can still make one where we talk stuff, how this one didn't make it, I guess. Yeah, that could be cool. Speaking of that, if you enjoy this a lot, or enough, let me know. That will really motivate me to do this stuff more. I really find it so awkward to just sit here and talk to myself. I guess that's with, like it is with everything, if I get a lot of practice, that's gonna be easier to do. So yeah, let me know if this is what you want to see more of, then I guess I'm gonna have to sit down and talk to my PC for a while. More often. Shut the rudder off there. And oh boy. Enemy fighters show up. Ah. What else can I come up with to talk about? Ah, right, there was the comment incident on the gun cam video recently where two guys got the same stuff completely wrong. Oh boy, yeah, it was just a rush, some kind of Russian kid, I think, who misunderstood and then proceeded to, like, blame all the commentators who liked the video for not knowing their history. Oh, so yeah, what happened? I guess most of you probably saw that, but whatever. I thought it was... I actually didn't get really angry at that this time for some reason. I often get kinda angry at some comments unnecessarily. I know I should, but whatever. This time I didn't. Krabby got angry though. So well, yeah, what happened was I made a video out of a bunch of gun cam footage where I attack B-17s in FW-190s, BF-109s, and in one or two scenes in the BF-110, I think. So, the first sentence of the video description obviously is something like US heavy bombers are attacked by blah 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 in 1943. Because obviously, what does obviously mean? The B-17s shown in the video, if you know your 8th Air Force stuff, have like late 1943 markings. 1945 B-17s or whatever would be silver, you know, whatever. So, I had a guy complain. Oh yeah, the video title obviously begins with IL-2 1946 because that's the name of the game I make the videos in, so I want to let people know, by the way, we are playing IL-2 1946, so that you know how the video footage is made. So we had a guy complain that an IL-2 would not be able to catch a B-29. Then I'm like, okay, I understand. And I even understand where the guy comes from. The guy is saying, if this is in 1946, when the war was over in reality, and there was a breakout of war between the US and the UdSSR, then the bomber the Americans would be using in 1946 would be the B-29. And obviously, a B-29 flies way higher and faster than an IL-2. And then he posted the technical data, like top speed and performance at altitude and stuff. Somebody got everything completely wrong. I mean, that this is the game title should be really, really obvious. First off, on the thumbnail, there's the game loop. IL-2 1946, yeah. And then, like, the video description has frequently asked questions. What game is this? IL-2 1946 version 4.1.3, whatever. And then, like, when you edit a video, when you upload a video, you can give details, like where it was recorded, what game you were playing, stuff like that. I always do that. And when you do that, YouTube displays the front cover of the game with game title, publisher, and when it was released under the video. And I'm like, yeah, I guess mentioning the game title 4 times isn't enough to let people know that that is the game title. You can get that wrong, but what was really annoying about that one, I guess, was that he proceeded to tell all the other people who liked the video that they didn't know their history. Like, learn history, you morons, or something he wrote to a lot of people. For some reason, YouTube did not delete that or like put that in the held for review category, like the comments that I have to approve, so that they are shown. No, that was fine. Just tell people that they are idiots for like 15 times, that's totally fine. But yeah, naming my Canadian friend by his in-game name, no, that's not at all. Yeah. And then the same day, another one was annoyed by the fact that there was 1946 in the video title. If that is too much to ask to properly understand that, the standards can't be too high these days. Speaking of low standards, that's really what I have for my own 190 landings. I don't like landing this aircraft one bit in this game. It always feels to me as if I'm about to stall when I'm like supposed to go 30 kilometers per hour slower or so to land. Yeah, the landing that is coming up is entertaining for sure. That's one of the really fun things about recording alone, when you have 7 kills or something, like I think I have at this point. And then you're like, okay, don't screw up the landing, don't screw up the landing, don't screw up the landing. I think I will stop the commentary at this point and just leave you to that landing. I hope that you like this. Let me know in the comments. If you want me to make more of this, you really have to like to tell me that you like it, you know. Anyway, bye!